We're going to start with solid agents. The very first topic is adsorption columns. And as you can imagine, we're going to check out what is adsorption. Now, the very first step to understand in adsorption is not to confuse with absorption, which is the process that we saw before, which is gas-liquid interaction. Remember, the solid of a gas goes into liquid, or vice versa. But in adsorption, the main key right here is that we're going to be working with the so-called surface of the solid, meaning that we have solids involved. Adsorption, also known as adsorptive separation, can be simply defined as the concentration of a given solid in the surface of the solid. This can either be a molecule of certain gas in a gas stream, or a dissolved material or a suspended substance in a liquid stream. So yes, we can have a feed which is vapor and liquid. They are going to be sticking into the surface of the solid, and then the main idea is, of course, to be able to separate it. The major applications, as you can imagine, if we're talking about liquid streams, is the separation of solids. So being able to select which materials are going to pass and which materials are not going to be sticking to the surface is huge of a deal. And the removal of impurities from gas streams. So I will say this is the main application in the industry, cleaning gases or passing gases through adsorption columns in order to remove certain materials, to clean catalyze, to recover material, etc. Now, probably you're wondering if these type of materials are the so-called barriers or membranes. Well, that's a good one. Technically, they are not, because we are focusing into the actual process that occurs, which is adsorption. So if there is adsorption, we will call this adsorption process. And if there is any kind of filtering or permeation, then we will call that a membrane. So that's the way we will go from now on. And the important streams to consider from now on is the adsorbed solute is going to be called the adsorbate, essentially the material that actually sticks into the so-called surface, and the solid material, which is the adsorbent. So before we even go, this could be silica, gel, or it can be also activated carbon, and so on. We're going to see later more options, but for now, I think it's good enough to start knowing which type of adsorption or adsorbents do we have. In a adsorption process, molecules or atoms or even ions in a gas or liquid will start diffusing from the fluid phase to the surface of the solid, where they will bond either chemically or more likely physically, or these type of interactions, weak intermolecular forces. So I would say these are the most common ones. So you can see here we got a bulk fluid, this is the phase, and they go to the solid. They start interacting, and in the surface of the solid, these materials are starting to, let's say, deposit or to bond or to get stick there via weak intermolecular forces. And as stated before, activated carbon or charcoal is one of the most common materials. Silica gel, alumina, and so on are going to be also important adsorbents. And let's keep going with some theory on adsorption, and then we continue to the industrial operation, which is the adsorption column.